softcore hentai, Josh. There's not going to be any pornography in our cute Yuri nurse visual novel. Might need to turn up the music. There we go. How was hockey? My team won, so hockey was nice. There is some lip-on-lip action, Josh. Domo, minasan. Kyo wa. Nurse Love Addiction. Oh, there's an actual Japanese name for it. But today we will be playing one of my favorite visual novels, the sequel to the previous visual novel that I played, Nurse Love Addiction. The previous visual novel being Nurse Love Syndrome. And apparently there was a combo pack where you could buy both of them, and it was called Nurse Love Obsession, which is kind of funny. And already we could tell that the art is a lot lighter. The music, I mean, music is background music. But the art is a lot more fluffy, a lot more light, and the overall pacing of the story is going to be probably similar to the last game. It took me about 26 hours to 100% this game last time, so the way I'm, and because I've already played through this, and it won't let me delete my, like, it won't let me delete my old save stuff, so basically what I'm gonna do is I am going to play through the game, play through the game as I would normally do on my first playthrough. But I do have an idea of who, what routes that I need to go down. You know what I mean? Let's get the show started. Yeah, back then it was, well, that was also the time where it was, like, really establishing myself as a VTuber, too. So I was giving VIP to a lot of people that stuck around since the beginning and, well, have been here since the beginning. You've got four screens split open. But yes, this is a very cute game. It's a very fun game. And the story is nice. It gets a little off the rails towards the end. But for the most part, it's a very cute game. It's got an interesting world. And I did mention that it is not a direct sequel to Nurse Love Syndrome. It is a sequel that takes place in the same world, but it is a different cast of characters and a different story. But of course it's nurses, so it's going to be quite similar. So give me one more second. I am going to go refill my drinks, which is something I neglected to do while I was letting the game load. So I will be right back, and then we will get this party started. Alright, I have gotten myself a glass of whiskey, courtesy of Safari Guy, who bought us some Suntory. That Japanese whiskey in a square bottle. It's pretty good. And I'm not much of a whiskey drinker, but I feel like having some whiskey on the rocks will be nice. I'm pretty nice at Mario Kart. I'll believe it when I see it. Well, let's get this show on the road. See? We're so close, and so far apart at the same time. Just as the stars in the night sky seem to almost overlap when they're really millions of light years apart. And yet, that's why I reach out my hand to distant stars. I reach out my hand. Looking back, I've had an easy life. Munya munya. Never thinking too much about anything. Without any dreams, significant goals, or long-term plans for my future, all that mattered to me was that I enjoyed myself day to day and was able to keep a smile on my face. After school, I would eat snacks with my friends and talk for hours. On my days off, I would lounge around my house doing nothing. I never thought to question my actions. I was allowed this lifestyle, so why should I feel bad about taking full advantage of it? I was like a jellyfish, floating aimlessly in the sea. Actually, I take that back. Even jellyfish, who don't appear to have much on their mind, may in fact have serious worries in life and long-term goals for their future. Oops. But my friends always used to tell me, Asuka, you're like a jellyfish, which didn't mean much coming from them since they were all pretty much the same. We joked about it, and even called ourselves the Jellyfish Club. Manager of this exclusive club? Yours truly. Club activities? None in particular. Just sitting around our classroom after school, eating snacks while teachers would make sarcastic comments as they passed by. In this way, time drifted by slowly. Munya munya. In the end, though, life is never that easy. Spring of my third year in high school found me facing my second career aptitude survey. During the first survey, which had been during winter of my second year, my friends and I hadn't given thought about towards our future careers and had written things like, no idea. But for that second survey held in spring, I had planned to once again write that I had no idea, when, looking around, I saw all my friends filling in their papers with serious expressions on their faces. I was like, hey! I asked them and they all said things like, I mean, we are third years after all. They said things like, come on, Asuka, don't pretend like you haven't given it thought as well. I was left in a state of shock. The Jellyfish Club came to an abrupt end and I was the last of the aimlessly floating jellyfish. That night, I spread out my survey papers in my room, sat down on my chair, moaning to myself. Was this the first time in my life I had truly felt worried? Thought about it for around 30 minutes. To put it more accurately, stunned by my own shallowness, I began to organize my closet. My reason for doing this did not seem to matter at the time. I began to pull things out from under my closet with a vigor that seemed to belong to someone planning to run away from home. Apparently, I was so loud that my younger sister, now, rushed into my room in surprise. With no clear purpose, I began going through my things, one after the other. Then from inside an old, firm cardboard box originally made from tangerines from Ehime Prefecture that was buried deep inside my closet, I found it. Yeah, our main character is really cute and adorable and probably a bit dumber than the last main character. But, I mean, all the characters in this game have their very good points. Especially little sister Chan over here. I keep accidentally scroll wheeling, which brings up that. I chose this moment to abruptly awaken. What? See, the thing that captured me about like the trailer for this game was the art style. It's so like light and fluffy and cute and like, oh, look at the cute little reindeer in the back. They have a poster for Nurse Love, the first game. That's funny. Vacantly, I gaze around at my surroundings. For a moment, I have no idea where I am before I regain my senses. Now, something like this looks like just a generic background, but like the characters are adorable. I'm inside Hakuran Dormitory, one of the student dorms at Taito Nursing Academy. Having graduated from high school in spring, this is the new home for us nursing students. All the rooms here are for two, and I, Asuka Osachi, am sharing mine with my younger sister, Nao. There's a cafeteria on the first floor of the dorm, but each room is also equipped with its own miniature kitchen, along with a bath and a toilet. Impressive. Nao is sitting down beside my bed and is looking at me. It's a bunk bed with me on the bottom bunk. Kaban means bag. Ah, I feel like, well, I guess no matter which side of the screen I'm on, I'm gonna be blocking some of the text. It just says, I'll prepare your bag for school. That's better. Yeah, it's the classic, responsible younger sister trope. I furrow my brow. Sure, this is the same scenario I witnessed every morning during my junior high and high school years, but... With an expression of puzzlement on her face, Nao obediently sits down on the carpet. She looks up blankly at me as I sit on the bed. Putting that aside, this girl is Nao, Nao Osachi. She is my younger sister by 1 year. She's kind, she loves looking after others, and she cares a lot about me. To explain to you just how much she cares, in her anxiety over my well-being, she joined the same nursing academy as me. Her excuse was that she just wanted to be together with her older sister. She calls herself my miracle drug. She picked up the nickname after I called her that once a long time ago. When we were in the same class in our high school years, the teacher called her the responsible Osachi sister, and they called me the irresponsible one. The reason why we're in the same school year isn't because I was held back a year, although people tend to jump to that conclusion. It's because my birthday is April 2nd and Nao's is April 1st of the next year. Thus, we happen to be at exactly opposite ends of the same academic year. Apparently, they call siblings like us miracle yearlings. Either that or, you know, she just came home from the hospital and got busy. Their mom, I mean. Yes, I had considered something. In my own way, I had considered it deeply. Seriously. And positively. Let me know if the music or anything is too loud.
Nao-chan にも自分のことを大
That being said, I should have thought of this long before we started out at the nursing academy. Alrighty. I figured that might be an issue. I turned it up earlier because it was like not very loud. Let's do that. Let's see how that works. After boldly announcing this, I puff out my chest in an attempt to express my dignified pride. A thoughtful look crosses Nao's face. My announcement of independence fails before it even begins, and all traces of my earlier dignity are scattered to the wind. In response to the encouragement from Nao to eat up quickly, I nod my head slowly. I eat the delicious breakfast, then yawn as I brush my teeth and wash my face, then yawn as I brush my hair, then I have Nao fix the stray hairs I can't manage on my own. Finally, I yawn as I change out of my pajamas. The trainee nurse uniform. We'll be wearing this from today until the day we become fully fledged in nurses. From today, I, Asuka Osachi, am a nursing student. In some ways, you could call this my battle uniform. Having originally thought we'd be able to wear traditional white uniforms, even while we were students, I was a little disappointed when I saw the training uniform on the academy's brochure. That being said, as I pass my arms through its sleeves, I feel my body ready itself for what's to come. I smile with satisfaction. What's up, Kakushi? How are you doing? Oops. Even as I think this, Nao seems to be contemplating something. Look at that solidarity from her sister. Nao is such a wonderful sister. I love her so much. Oh yeah, dude, I wasn't even thinking about that. Like, I was just like, you know what? It's been about a year since I've played the last Yuri Nurses. Let me play the next one. I mean, it's not even like there's too much romance in this. Stepping out of our dorm, there's a steady flow of students heading to the academy. Since no one is in their uniforms, everyone is dressed differently, but it's easy to spot the first-year students by how little they seem to blend in with the dorm and their surroundings. I suppose that Nao and I probably peer that way to those around us as well. The spring sun shines down on us. Nao and I walk next to each other down Seiseki Yurigaoka, an area known for its many hills. Still somewhat sleepy, I continue to yawn.
またあの絵 半と一緒に寝てたんだねって。怖い、ベッドから落ちかけてたよ。
Yeah, if you're wondering, you have not missed much. We're just introducing the two characters here. Main character is on the right, Asuka-chan. And then on the left is our little sister, who is 364 days younger than us. Now. The picture book. The book that now mentioned is what emerged from the cardboard box in my cupboard during my second career aptitude survey in the spring of my third year of high school. That's a mouthful. On the cover, in child handwriting, it reads, "This belongs to Asuka." Let's see, Hoshi wo uhito. Hoshi wo uhito. Interesting. Thank you for your subscription, Scroff, for 3 months. You see Yuri nurses, you click. I'm doing pretty fine. Maya, we watched the hockey game in Discord earlier. The Flyers won. And now I am enjoying some Suntory while I play some Yuri nurses. Without giving it much thought, I'd opened the cover of the picture book and I'd found the words written on the last page. It wasn't much more than a scribble. Written in my messy childhood handwriting, it said, "I'm gonna be a nurse!" Let's see, I can't read this one in the middle. But he ni naru? Kan something hininaru? Kango? Maybe. He's 2 years older than me, but they're one day apart. That's funny. I think everyone goes through that, don't they? Where we grow up and find maybe our elementary school notebook or our kindergarten drawing book, and there we rediscover our innocent dreams of what we're gonna be when we grow up that we'd long forgotten about. I think about that sometimes too, and you know, when I was a little kid, I wanted to be a construction worker, then a barber, then a sports announcer, and then a football player, then an architect. Well, architect was in high school. And we say to ourselves, what was I thinking back then? Things like becoming the president or a Ghostbuster. Actually, those are the better ones. Sometimes you see kids who say they want to be cabbage. Yeah, you thought you were going to become a vegetable? In that way, I'm sure most of us have experienced being surprised by our own dreams of what we're going to be when we grow up. And what I had written was nurse. And that's the reason why I'm here right now. The girl who chased stars. I whisper the title of the picture book as I trot off. It was something of a mysterious picture book. The story was set in the world of the stars. Pictures on each page and the simple words written in large font means there was no mistaking it for anything other than a child's picture book. However, the poetically written words were abstract and surprisingly deep. Finding the interpretations difficult even in my third year of high school, I had considered how incomprehensible it must have been for me as a child. What must you do to catch a star? The picture book had begun by posing this question to the reader. How to catch a star? In my case, I had planned to do that by writing, "I'm gonna be a nurse." If that were the case... Makes me wonder, if she's such a dope, how did she get into this nursing school? I must be the only one amongst all the nursing students who doesn't know why she's trying to become a nurse. In some ways, it almost feels like as if I'm reaching out my hands aimlessly towards the stars. A normal nurse. I don't know what yuri nurses do. Well, they're like normal nurses, except they like to kiss other girls. After a 15-minute walk from our dorm, we arrive in front of the academy. That's about a mile. Taito Nursing Academy. From today, as nursing students, this is a school we will be attending. It is a 3-year study program, and all students are required to live in the dorms. Taito Nursing Academy is apparently one of the larger and more prestigious nursing academies in the country, so it really drives home how the hell did our main character get into this school? And she even wonders that too, look at this! I think this nonchalantly, but it's really all due to Nao's flawless, relentless tutoring. With yesterday being the entrance ceremony and having already come to pick up our textbooks, today is not our first day coming to the academy. Still, somehow. School building in front of us suddenly seems completely different than yesterday. Not yet. Just quoting you, Kakushi. Nao's eyes are round circles of surprise. Even like this, she looks adorable. Putting that aside, sometimes nurses are referred to as white-robed angels, but I feel a little too embarrassed to say it aloud, especially since it is now what we're trying to become. Her voice. These first words I uttered are colored with surprise. Ah, it's our teacher. Right! I remember the teacher now. Miss Ohara stands on the podium and greets us. The fact that she's wearing a white uniform is certainly part of it, but a white-robed angel is the perfect way to describe her. She appears untainted, lovely and dignified at the same time. She seems to be cut from my imagination of what I would consider the perfect nurse. I almost can't believe people like her actually exist! She smiles. Her white uniform and her nurse's cap, I couldn't imagine it suiting anyone more than her. I'm truly moved. Next to me, Nao also has a look of admiration on her face. Ripples of excitement spread through the classroom. Oh my god, Miss Ohara, you're so pretty! Some suck-up cries out, unable to contain herself. Even in response to these voices, she calmly responds, "Thank you." I hear excited whispers in my ears of people saying things like, "Ohara? That Ohara?" and "No way." "That Ohara?" As if hearing this question, Miss Ohara gives a small nod. She smiles at us. Once again, ripples of excitement spread through the classroom. Putting together the conversations around me, I grasp that the Nightingale Award is a national award given annually to nurses who have distinguished themselves by accomplishing remarkable work. Only one or two nurses are awarded the prize every year. One of them was Miss Ohara's elder sister, Sumire Ohara. On top of that, one of Miss Ohara's parents is a famous surgeon, while the other is a renowned professor of medicine. Furthermore, one of her grandparents is the chairman of a pharmaceutical company. In other words, she's the daughter of an elite medical family. As if this weren't enough, according to the voices from behind my seat,
Nana's a nurse, I heard. 本当は大原先生もナイチンゲール賞もらうはずだったんだって。なのに辞退したらしいよ。特別扱いされたくないからって。
The words involuntarily escape my lips.
お姉ちゃん、言葉遣い。
Now warns me in a small voice.
でも、すごい人が担任になってくれたね。
Now also seems excited. I nod over and over again.
はい。では入学式も済んで、今日から学校が始まりますが、今日のところは年間学習スケジュールについてお話ししますね。
Hey, it's syllabus day, no classes. Miss O'Hara begins passing out papers. As she hands the papers to the students in the front row seats, Miss O'Hara not only seems to be the perfect nurse, but the perfect teacher as well.
先生って若く見えるけど何歳なんですか？
人に年齢を聞くのはデリケートな質問ですよ。ペーシェント、患者さんの中には気にされる方もいますから、聞くならもっと上手に聞いてくださいね。
Laughter follows Miss O'Hara's response. After that, until the papers are distributed completely, questions fly at Miss O'Hara as if this were some miniature press conference. Miss O'Hara carefully answers the serious questions and skillfully brushes aside the ones that are not. Before she became a teacher, she worked as a nurse at a university hospital for 4 years. This is her second year working as a teacher and her first to have her own class. She charmingly adds that she's a little nervous about this responsibility. Her measurements? Unknown. Current romantic status? Unknown. Her favorite food is Italian, and her favorite dessert is cheesecake. Hey! She sounds like my brother.
おいしい店を探すのもいいですが、自分で作るのも楽しいですね。
How can I put it? She's flawless. Alright, nothing like my brother. Miss O'Hara skillfully reverts the class's attention to their studies, and we all follow her lead.
プリントを見ながら聞いてください。まず先生が担当するのは。
I obediently look down at my papers and experience a moment of vertigo.
難しそうな科目ばっかり。
Environment theory, pathology, microbiology, clinical testing, information science, counseling. My mind spirals.
この中から好きなの2、3個チョイスして、それをやればいいのかな。
Oh, come on, of course I know it won't be that easy.
先生が担当するのは、数学、英語などの基礎学科。
I have a tickle up my nose.
それから、看護総合論。これは、看護全般に関する知識を包括的に学ぶ授業ですね。解剖生理学や病理学といった専門的な領域は、大学から教授方に来ていただいて講義してもらいます。座学以外で先生が受け持つのは基礎看護技術。1年の間はまだ実践的な看護実習は行いませんが、ベッドメイキングや正式といった大事な技術学習を行いますので、しっかり学んでください。それから。
As if in a dream, Miss O'Hara's words seem to be growing further away. Still, I try my best to pick up Miss O'Hara's words even as I glance to one side. Fuck is it? It's visual novel, what do you expect? Now is tilting her head at an odd angle as she looks at Miss O'Hara. Huh? I wonder what the matter is.
なんでだろう? 先生って...
Now whispers. Her voice grows quiet near the end and I cannot hear what she says. It's after school now. Just as Miss O'Hara had said, today there are no actual classes and we are dismissed at noon. Syllabus day. After the explanation of the yearly curriculum, we have a time allotted for student introductions. All of us students take turns saying our name and why we wanted to become nurses. When it's my turn, I think about it for a while before deciding that I'll just tell the truth.
Osachi Asuka desu. Kankoshi ni naro to omotta ryuu wa
You are strange for enjoying ASMR. That's why you come to my streams, because I am beautiful ASMR. For a moment, I seemed to sense a small current of unease ripple through the classroom. There's nothing wrong with visual novels. It's just like a regular novel, except they're voice acted. As for now... Hey man, I'm sure you listen to audiobooks. It's the same thing, except it comes with pictures. She wore her words like a badge of pride. As her elder sister, I'm not sure what to make of that. Well, in any case, we somehow managed to get through our self-introductions. I tell her with a serious expression on my face. I tell her with a serious expression on my face. Now turns to look at me. Now smiles at me as she waves her hand and I head to the bathroom. After replying to the call of nature, I wash my hands at the sink. I flash myself a rare, sharp glance in the mirror, and, satisfied, I head out of the bathroom. Passing by the stairway leading to the classroom, I walk at a brisk pace down the hallway. If anyone had observed me, they would have said I seemed to be on the verge of running away. How could I help myself? Then, just as I reach the edge of the stairway, I turn toward the stairway as if drawn towards it. No thoughts inhabit my mind. Relatable. Just the feeling of being drawn and pulled like an object by gravity. And there, I feel as if I've seen a star. Just for a moment, a small yet bright sparkle. A shining star, taking human form. On my way from the first floor, where the first year classroom is, going up to the second floor, I come across two, most likely, nursing students. The first girl who enters my vision is an image of elegant beauty. The girl right behind her wears glasses and looks intelligent. She also has a surprisingly beautiful features. I stop in my tracks and gaze at the two of them. The two of them, noticing my presence, also stop and look at me. Both of them are extremely beautiful, and yet, I don't know if that's the reason why I froze. I simply stare vacantly at her. Who knows how much time passes? Braves are about to win, let's go. Damn, she was just called stupid. Questioning gaze turns to a glare as she speaks. I feverishly apologize, but still, I cannot seem to remove my gaze from her. Even as I think this, the other girl, the one wearing glasses, lets out a giggle. I like the green-haired girl. Seemingly unaffected by the rebuke, the girl called Itsuki calls her by her name. Sakuya. What a beautiful name. From their well-controlled and calm demeanor, I make the assumption that they are senior students. I shake my head frantically from side to side. Huh? They're the same year as me? Ignoring me and my doubts about them being first years, they begin to argue in the middle of the stairway. Not so much arguing, more bantering. Each year's intake at Taito Nursing Academy consists of one class of about 60 students. Earlier today, I hadn't seen the two of them in the classroom. There were quite a few students, but each one of us had introduced ourselves, so I'm confident about my observation. Perhaps that was why I had the thought they were senior students without giving it much thought. See, look at how cute she is over here. A girl called Sakuya responds to me. She continues to look at me with something resembling a glare. So the two of them are first years, and will be living in the dorms from now. Will they be in Hakuran Dormitory? So says the girl called Sakuya. Look at the way she's holding her hand. Classic Himedere move. She's about to flip her hair at me. She then proceeds to descend the stairway, and without glancing towards me, she walks briskly past. Oh! As she disappears into the distance, I frantically call out behind her. However, as if completely ignoring me, the rhythm of her feet does not change. Does she already dislike me? Aww. Oh. While I was distracted by the other girl, the girl called Itsuki had descended the stairway and is standing right in front of me. She gazes intently at me. The first thought that runs through my head is that she's tall. Seeing her close up, I realize for the first time that behind her designer glasses, her eyes are a beautiful blue. Is she not fully Japanese? As she gazes at me with those eyes, I feel myself falter. Did she just laugh at me? I I hear her voice from off in the distance.
Hi, hi, Ohime-sama. Jane, Nukeko.
She gracefully waves a hand at me and pulls away. However, the moment before she pulls away, for a split second she draws her face up to mine and whispers in my ear. Her voice is quiet, yet clear.
Usa da yo.
Those are her words.
What?
As my mind remains blank, unable to comprehend the meaning of her words, she walks off to follow the girl called Sakuya, and I am left alone, standing in a daze. Huh? Not what it seems. Does she mean that someone isn't telling the truth? About what? Wait, before that, I remember her saying something weird. Something like, I found you. It makes no sense for someone I just met to tell me something like that. It makes no sense, but... No. Wait. More importantly... Nurses are naughty or nice? They're nice for the most part. Seriously, what the hell? Nante ya ne.
Oh, sore wa Takeda Sakuya-san to Anata Itsuki-san da ne.
As we make our way home from the academy, Nao surprises me by saying this.
Shitteru no, Nao-chan? Datte class meibo ni namae wa notteru shi.
I haven't even thought to look at that yet.
Kinō no nyūgakushiki demo class no kotachi ga wadai ni shite tan da yo.
I was mostly asleep for the entrance ceremony. I truly am a dummy girl.
Futari tomo nyūgakushiki ni wa kite nakatta ndakedo, onaji kōkō datta kō ga ite ne. Kikarete mo nai no ni iroiro shabette tan da. Takeda-san wa ie ga mukashi kara tsuzuiteru shisanka de, Amato-san wa dentou buyō no meika no musume de, futari tomo ojō-sama nan datte.
We're gonna bag ourselves a rich girl, baby.
Kangō gakkō ni shingaku suru tte kimeta toki, gakkō chotto shita sawagi ni natta rashii yo.
Actually, when I decided to enroll at this nursing academy, it caused a bit of an uproar as well. In my case, it was for somewhat different reasons. I think back on the two of them, Miss Takeda was, however you'd look at it, the ultimate embodiment of a high-class girl. Miss Amato, well, she definitely didn't appear to come from a working-class family. More I think of it, the less I understand.
じゃん。あ、うん。それで?他には2人とも成績優秀で、アマトさんなんかトップ入学したとか。本当は入学式で新入生の当時読む予定だったんだって。あとは2人は高校の頃から美人カップルで有名だったとか。
I feel like I've been hit by a brick. See, Yuri nurses, I told you. There they were. Just missed them, flew right by you. In my admiration, an odd, strangled sound escapes my lips. But thinking back, it makes sense. Yes, the two were a perfect match. Well-bred girls, distinguished and beautiful. And lovers.
きれいな人だった。うん。すごくね。へえ。アマトさんも綺麗だったけど、武田さんは星みたいな。星キラキラって?
なんていうか。よくわかんない。
unable to explain myself properly, I resort to laughter. I tell Nao what happened in front of the stairway. How I started and stared and gawked at her. How she had ignored me when we had parted. Perhaps because I had looked so pensive when I told her, a downcast expression appears on Nao's face. Nao says this in a troubled voice. It's true. Being disliked by someone you're going to spend the next 3 years studying with doesn't sound ideal at all. Where's the addiction? You're about to get addicted. Look at how adorable these girls are. At a time when we need to combine our strengths to become nurses, at a time when I need to catch my star, a sigh involuntarily escapes my lips. We continue to walk on in silence for a while. A little before we reach our dorm, Nao speaks. They have an emoji in the text. I clutch her tightly in an embrace as I cry tears of gratitude. Of course I'll do whatever I can on my own. But in any case, my days of independence from my sister seem a long way off yet. Our conversation turns to what we'll be eating for lunch as we enter our dorm. Suddenly though, Nao changes the topic. Anybody remember the last game? I'm gonna be a pretty nurse! They even use the same fucking background for the hospital beds. She's my favorite. I forgot that the teacher can be romanced in this game. Whoa, spoilers! I do have water right here. No politics in the Twitch chat, my man. In the Discord voice chat where the nobody can take screenshots, it's fine. Yep. I forgot a lot about this game. I mean, it has been a long time since I played it, but like the thing I remember most the first time I played through this game was after I beat it, I was like, I needed to talk to someone that knows about this game, about how much I loved playing this game. And it's weird how that works, you know? It's like, I loved this game when I first finished it, and then I hadn't touched it in like 3-4 years, and now I'm playing it again, and it's like, yeah, I remember a lot now. It's so lesbian. Honestly, that was the initial draw to this game, but it is a very good game. It's very cute. It's beautiful. Music, I mean, you can't go wrong with visual novel music. It's just simple piano background music. But I mean, it's all nice. It's a great game. Highly recommend it. It's $35 on Steam, or you can buy the bundle for the Nintendo Switch. That night, as I get inside my bed, I think back on Nao's words. Even I am aware of what this term means. In fact, anyone who aspires to be a nurse is most likely aware of this strange power. Just by touching someone, they can remove that person's pain and suffering and ease the symptoms of their sickness. Among the general population, it's usually put down to the placebo effect, and it's lumped in with other superstitions and old wives' tales. Yet apparently Miss Takeda and Miss Amato have this power. If it comes to magic charms, then Nao can use them too. Every year during the rainy season, I'm plagued by headaches. However, whenever this happens, Nao casts a charm on me that helps ease the pain. Nao says this, and we sit with out legs folded under us. I found a typo. And we sit with our legs folded under us, facing each other. Then, drawing our faces close, we let our foreheads touch. Mao's voice slowly drifts towards me. I hate that, dude. I hate this. Make the pain go away, but backwards!
Yawa og nia petakam!
The words of the charm that Nao thought up. I'm pretty sure that, like, in Japanese, she's actually saying some words, but this is dumb. It's a childish charm. Simply reversing the words make the pain go away. But the effect has always been immediate. As Nao would continue to say the charm, my headache would simply float away and disappear. I wonder if that's the same thing. I hear Nao's quiet voice from the bed above mine. It seems she's still awake.
Look at your cute pajamas.
I wish I had a healing forehead. Fucking headbutt walls and shit. In the darkness, both of us giggle.
おやすみ。
Even though we already said goodnight earlier, we say it again. Then.
あ、そうだ。明日は自分で起きるから。
I doubt it. I doubt you will do that. And off to sleep I go.
白衣性愛情依存症。
もんにゃもんにゃもんにゃ。
お姉ちゃん、起きて、起きて。
おはよう。今日はさおちゃん起きれたでしょ。
My second attempt at independence from now ends in failure. Better luck next time, me. She's not in her scrubs. I see both Miss Takeda and Miss Amato in the classroom. Oh, both of them are staying at the same Hakuran dormitory as us. I found out this morning when I saw them walking ahead of us on our way to the academy.
Eh, 昨日はすみませんでした、大原先生。
どうもどうも。
The two of them gather the attention of everyone in the classroom. So that's what it's like to be famous. Can't wait to be famous.
授業が始まるのは今日からですから。ただ、入学式に出られなかったのは残念でしたね。では、朝のホームルームを始める前に、二人にはクラスのみんなに自己紹介をしてもらいましょうか。武田さんから。
Miss O'Hara calls out Miss Takeda. Miss Takeda stands up. I gaze up at Miss Takeda, but she shows no sign of noticing me.
武田咲也です。私が看護の道を志したのは、それが自分のすべきことだと思ったから。それだけです。
Miss Takeda simply says this and sits down. The aura of greatness about her is palpable. A low "Oh" rumbles throughout the classroom.
でも、具体的には何も言ってないような。
Don't call her out, Asuka. Next, Miss Amato smoothly stands up from her chair.
Amato Itsuki. 私は趣味と実益を兼ねてかな。詳しくは内緒。
She's a dork. She says this and sits down in one smooth motion. Who keeps things secret during an introduction?
ミステリアス気取りか。
お姉ちゃんがイチャモンつけてばっかりのヤシウマさんみたいになってる。
And yet small gasps of "Whoa!" echo throughout the classroom. Everyone is loving it. No fair! Sitting down, Miss Amato turns towards me and lets out a giggle before silently moving her lips to form the words, "Dummy girl." I thought when she had said it's not what it seems that she had been telling me to not take the nickname to heart, that it was a joke. But I guess that wasn't the case. Has she meant to say that those words were not what they seemed? In any case, I have no idea what she's talking about.
はい、二人ともありがとう。では、ホームルームを始めますね。
Miss O'Hara's smile is just as flawless today. Her soft voice flows through the classroom.
今日は午後の授業で早速基礎看護技術の実習がありますが、皆さん実習着はちゃんと持ってきていますか？
One class at the nursing academy runs for 90 minutes. There are two classes each morning and two each afternoon. The first class is English. The second is anatomical physiology. Kind of a big difference in the curriculum there, you know, learning how to conjugate verbs. And then the next portion is, you know, this is where the knee bone connects to the hip bone. So let me explain to you what anatomical physiology is. Basically, it's a class where we learn about the mechanisms and motions of the body's organs, skeleton, and so on. I open the textbooks, and my initial reaction is that it's filled with visual images, especially in contrast to the English and math books. Yeah, I got pictures in my books.
Wow, 人体ってすごい!
However, my amusement is short-lived. I underestimated the gravity of the situation. Well, I have a tendency of doing that. After all, I am the manager of the Jellyfish Club. The teacher of the anatomical physiology class is talking. I thought humans had more bones than that. You don't even have to get a 50 to pass the test. That's insane. The teacher's tone is friendly, but the words resound within the classroom. Within me. Why did I have to say I'm gonna be a nurse when I was a kid? Do you suppose not being able to remember the names of the bones would disqualify me from the Nightingale Award? I wonder if amongst the winners of the Nightingale Award, there was someone who didn't remember the names of the bones at all. Yeah, highly unlikely. After class, resembling something like a used tea bag, I weakly get up from my chair. With a worried expression on her face, Nao waves to me and I head out to the hallway. I open the classroom door and run into Miss Takeda. Perhaps she had gone to the bathroom, but when she looks up at me in shock at the perfect timing with which we had both opened the door, most likely my face mirrors her expression. There's a slightly dubious expression on Miss Takeda's face as she speaks. I scramble away from the front of the door. Miss Takeda passes me as if I don't exist, or so I think for a moment. Suddenly, she stops and turns towards me. We're now face to face. And close. I gaze at her face. My heart skips a beat at how beautiful she is. So she had remembered my name from my introduction yesterday. Oh, this is the scene where she's gonna get mad at her for thinking that being a nurse is a game. Yeah, I called it. Without any further words, she enters the classroom. Did she just say something mean and cold? I think she did, but... Huh? I'm sure she did, but... I clutch my chest. There's no pain. I shake my head and turn around. I follow her form with my eyes. I see her flowing hair and her graceful back, a back that rejects any attempt on my part to initiate conversation. Yeah, it's the same haku that's used in hakuho. Lunch break finishes and afternoon classes begin. This fucking localization. Oh my god! I'm just like so nervous! Having changed into our training uniforms, we have all gathered in the training room. Rows of white beds are laid out between each bedstand, several students. Even as she says, I'm nervous too, Nao seems completely fine. Of course, amongst the students, I can see Miss Takeda and Miss Amato as well. Neither of them show any signs of being nervous as they talk about something between themselves. For the most part, Miss Amato seems to be whispering in Miss Takeda's ear as she responds in an offhand manner. But sometimes... Look at how cute they are! They're so cute, look at them! Sometimes a small smile forms on her lips. The bell sounds and the front door of the training room opens. Miss Ohara walks in. During homeroom this morning, she had been dressed in her own clothes, but now she's wearing her white uniform. I reconfirm my earlier assessment that the white uniform and nurse's cap truly suit Miss Ohara perfectly. I guess, like our training uniform, she only wears it during training. Wait, but then, why was she wearing her white uniform yesterday? Was it her way of welcoming us new students? I thought so. She probably accidentally put on the uniform to go to work that day. Miss Ohara's words send a slight jolt down my back. We all respond in confirmation. Miss Ohara comes to the front of the bed. A new sheet, folded in four, has been placed on top of the bed. She smiles. Responding to Miss Ohara's angelic smile, we all gather around the bed. Then... Miss Ohara moves her hands slowly, most likely to make it easier for us to comprehend. I watch her as she carefully makes the bed. I can't help myself from imagining white wings sprouting from her back. In fact, I doubt anyone would be able to prevent that image from forming in their mind. We silently take in her words. From all around, I can hear the sounds of scribbling pens as students take notes. I watch Miss Ohara as if I'm being drawn into her. That's a given, I think. Miss Ohara's words flow, her body never taking a moment to rest as she moves serenely and gracefully. 7-0. They're playing in Houston, right? I hear Miss Takeda whisper quietly. Responding to her voice, I look towards her, and our eyes meet. I was saying this to a Murgle the other day, like, it probably sucks. I mean, it doesn't suck to win the World Series, but it's gonna suck to not win at home in front of the home crowd, you know what I mean? Smile, smile. Give her a friendly smile, just like Miss Ohara's smile. Turns away and ignores me. Eek! Mission failed. We'll get him next time. Miss Ohara says this without seeming to look in my direction. I quickly return my gaze. Even though Miss Ohara's actions are slow, she makes no unnecessary movements and she's already applying the finishing touches to the bed making.
そして最後に、個室でない限り他のベッドには患者さんがいますから、バタバタして埃を立てないように静かに手早く行うこと。
Well, I will say, after Atlanta threw the Super Bowl to the Patriots, they definitely deserve something. And I guess they're going to have a World Series. Mergle actually went to see, Game 3? So I hope he's having a fantastic... He's probably at the stadium. He's probably there, too. Miss Ohara runs her hand over the newly placed sheet, smoothing out the few micro creases left. Then she looks at us. The bed that Miss Ohara has made with her own hands looks undeniably inviting. Atlanta's your team? I thought you said you lived in Florida. Or New Orleans. It seems to glimmer white. Just as I think such thoughts, she abruptly calls on me. What a cute voice, like, listen to this. What? In the top part of Florida near Alabama and Georgia. Ah, gotcha. So you're in the panhandle. You're too far away from, Tampa. Miss Amato suppresses her voice as she laughs. Damn it. I look and see that Miss Takeda also has an exasperated expression on her face. But what's done is done. As Miss Ohara's demonstration finishes, we all begin practicing on individual beds. At first, Miss Ohara tells us to work in pairs to a single bed. Nao and I are paired together and stand on opposite sides. Nao flashes me a smile. I'll be alright. I did space out a little, but I had been watching Miss Ohara's movements properly and had been listening to the instructions. Besides, it's not just me, but the two of us. This'll be a walk in the park. However... Before my eyes, a bed so tragically made that if I took a nap on it, I would be guaranteed to have nightmares. The sheets are a mess. The original sheet and replacement sheet seem to have somehow managed to tangle together, leaving us unable to discern which is which. It could possibly pass as some bizarre piece of modern art, or mysteriously entangled life forms. Maybe? How do you fail making a bed of all things? Nao looks at me apologetically, but of course the responsibility lies with me. Nao covers her mouth. I look on with a serious expression on my face. Miss Ohara had walked over to our bed. I'm embarrassed for her to see the tragic-looking bed, but Miss Ohara doesn't laugh upon seeing our travesty. Instead, she gives us precise instructions, and, like magic, we manage to return the bed to its original state. Then she looks at me and smiles. Being spoken to gently in this way, it's all I can do to stop myself from crying. A while later... There, in front of me. Well, you'd have to be fairly odd to want to sleep in a bed like this, but but I managed to make it into something that is recognizable as something that's supposed to function as a bed. This is the finished product of my bed making. Miss Ohara says with a wry laugh. Understandably, she has to be tough on me this time. The 30 points are like a jab through my heart. These noises, man. Miss Ohara smiles her angelic smile. She distances herself from our bed and moves on to another pair. It's Miss Takeda and Miss Amato's bed. Miss Takeda touches the newly laid out sheet with her hand.
いいえ、まだまだだわ。結構面白かったよ。思ったより骨がいるね、これ。ベッドで人が寝てる状態でもやるんでしょ?大原先生、次は一人でやってみてもいいですか?え、そうですね。なら次は。
As I listen to their voices, I look down at my bed and mutter. I wonder if they have negative scores. Pardon me. Later that day, as we make our way home from school, for some reason, we're walking with Miss Takeda and Miss Amato. Well, we do belong to the same class and the same dorm, so it's not odd that we'd end up together on our way home. Now and I, and a little distance away, Miss Takeda and Miss Amato. Now observes my silence questioningly. I try laughing for no reason. Positioned between myself and Miss Takeda, although at some distance, now casts furtive glances between the two of us. Then,
Takeda-san, bed making good.
Now strikes up a friendly conversation, and Miss Takeda looks somewhat surprised momentarily. However, she quickly regains her composure.
So, ne. Sensei kara mo so itte moraeta no wa yokatta keredo. Haru yasumi, jishu tore shita kai ga atta tte koto ne, hime. Dakara, gakkou de sono yobikata wa. Hai, sensei. Zugakuro wa gakkou ni hairanai to omimasu.
Each time Miss Amato calls Miss Takeda princess, a troubled look flits across her face, which is unfortunate because the name suits her. Anyway, now is not the time to be thinking thoughts like that. Yeah, you got fat. Miss Takeda lets out a sigh. I've exasperated her again.
いつきも余計なこと教えないで。いいじゃん。天才ぶりたいわけじゃないんでしょ?最初はいきなり私をベッドに寝かせてやるんだから、こっちは落っこちまくって青あざだらけ。
Miss Takeda's face is bright red. I only giggled slightly, but in response, she stares daggers at me. Eek! My first impression of the two of them from yesterday at the stairway, the soft, elegant Miss Takeda and the cool, intelligent Miss Amato. But it seems I may have been wrong about them, and the way they are now is who they really seem to be. The distance between me and Miss Takeda, I feel both as if we've gotten closer and further apart at the same time. I'm going to use this opportunity to go to the bathroom, so I will be right back. Is there really no background music in this scene? Hold on. There's no background music, I'll go until there is. Then, on our first day off since entering Taito Nursing Academy... Now I'll go to the bathroom.
Thank you.
now probably is the best character. You're right about that one. Alrighty. Back to L game. In our dorm room, I sit lifelessly at the table, moaning. Ever since school started, every day we've been tied down by technical classroom lectures and training. With no regard to the fact that we're new students in our first week of study. On the table, a cup of the green tea now had made for me sits there steaming. Perhaps since until elementary school I had been grandma's little girl, I'm more used to drinking traditional green tea than coffee or black tea. Now is currently sitting at her study desk and, most likely, reviewing this week's classes. She is such a good girl. Well, I know I have to do it too. I know, but... I consider such pathetic thoughts in my heart. I sipped the green tea and let out a lazy sigh. I remember what my teacher had written in my report card when I was in elementary school. Habit of being lazy. When excited about something, she sets extremely high goals for herself, but compromises immediately. Lacks perseverance. No self-discipline. Ruthless, but spot on, Miss Toyama. Now in response to my murmurings as she continues to look at her notebook. Ah, I thought you were gonna be at the stadium, Murgle. I'm glad that you guys won. I grunt and get up. I head towards the toilet near the entrance of our room. I think to myself that once I finish using the bathroom, I'll follow Nao's example and review our studies as well. Thinking such thoughts, I walk to the door. Standing there is a skeleton. Bones, skeletal structure, life-sized, complete. Our eyes meet as its empty sockets gaze at me. I rush back and collapse onto the floor next to Nao. Now grins and says, Now's words bring back my memory. I'll do that at the end of the stream, alright, Murgle? Is it We Are the Champions? Yes, it is. Or I'll play that the next time I go to the bathroom or something. I tremble.
まだ一個だけだから。
嘘。I scramble back to in front of the toilet. That clearly does not label all 206 bones. There is indeed a copy of a life-size anatomical chart spread out and glued to the door. There are lines branching from each bone, leading to their specific names. The name of the only one of them is hidden by a light blue post-it. It's the name of the lowest bone located on the center of the chest. I don't know, that's clearly pointing to the arm right there. The bone above it is labeled as the sternum. Now, what's the one below it called? That's the question. Cast a glimpse towards Nao. She's facing her desk again and is looking away from me. If I'm gonna do it, now's my chance. I think I'll cheat. After all, I really need to use the toilet. At this rate, I'll end up becoming Wet Pants Asuka. I must avoid that at all costs. That's some foreshadowing. I gulp down my anxiety and, eyeing Nao, I place my fingers onto the post-it. Take a quick glimpse at it, pretend like I just remembered the name. Alright, I can do this. Just a quick, tiny glimpse. Jira! Zephoid process? Now, surprised voice. In the end, I put aside my pride and tell Nao honestly. I realized then, of course, that I had no reason to worry about peeing my pants. Apparently, the X in Zephoid process is pronounced as a Z. Nao teaches me how to pronounce the word, and so my anxiety is laid to rest. However... Later that day, at dinner... Saying this, Nao lays out the freshly cooked food on the table. Wait, she makes so many cute noises. Looking at the food, I realize something is unusual. Fried chicken with the bones in? That's ridiculous. Who has bone in chicken? I mean, come on. Nao grins at me. The music. Nao continues to grin. In the end, when Nao switches into gear, she becomes hardcore with her Spartan-style teaching, although she's still gentle. Oh, this reminds me of when we were studying for our exams. Early afternoon, I'm walking my usual route to school when... I hear the sound of a screaming child. I change my direction towards where the crying is coming from. Then... The two of them are there.
血も出てる。
ガードレールから落ちたくらいでか。たくんるせ。
Yeah, me too.
いつき。
はいはい、すんませんでした。で、病院連れてくしかないんじゃない？それじゃ。
ちょっと泣き止ませないと動かすのは難しいわね。ほら、おとなしくして。病院に連れて行ってあげるから。
やだー、痛いよ
だから、その痛いのを治療するために病院連れてくんでしょうが。って言ってもわかんないか。
子供が落っこちて怪我して、それを何とかしようとしてる？
Miss Takeda and Miss Amato, it seems like what's going on, but for some reason, all I can do is hide in the shadows and watch them. Why am I hiding?
なんか、勢いと言いますか。別に野獣馬とかそんなんじゃなくて。
So I attempt to justify my actions.
しゃあねえな。よし、私にやらせて。
いつき？
もうここで傷塞いじまおう。そうすりゃガキもおとなしくなるでしょう。
あなた、癒しの手を。
うん、まあね。てか、とっとと黙らせたい、そのガキ。
今、癒しの手って言った？
武田さんと天藤さん、癒しの手持ってるんだって
。姫、ほら。
いえ、いつき。それなら私がやるわ。
え？
この子を見つけたのは私だし、それに。
Here, Miss Takeda falls silent for a moment.
私の方が上手に使えるわ。
まあ、そうだけどさ。わかった。じゃあ任せるよ。
All I can do is stare at them from the shadows. Healing hands?Really?
あなた、ちょっとの間だけじっとしてなさい。すぐに痛くなくなるから。
Miss Takeda says this as if to reassure the child. Then...
ああ、もう、ここからじゃ子供に何してるのかよく見えないよ。
And I am curious. So curious. Curious George.Must be involuntarily craning forward in my excitement so that I can see more. More!
はい、もう傷塞がったわ。どう？
あ、本当だ！もう全然痛くないよ！頭、全然痛くない！すごい！お姉ちゃん、魔法使いなの！
Miss Takeda says this, making no attempt at showing off. Once I get back home, I tell Nao what I saw on my way home from school.
武田さんと天藤さんが癒しの手持ってるの。すごいよね、魔法使いって言われてたし。
お姉ちゃん。
As I enthusiastically tell her what happened, Nao doesn't seem nearly as impressed.
はい。
今聞いた限りだと、お姉ちゃんは。実際に子供の頭の傷が塞がってるところを見たってわけじゃないみたいだけど、そういうことでいいのかな？
うん。
じゃあまだわかんないんじゃないかな、魔法みたいな力か。子供って特にそういうプラシーボとかおまじないみたいなのを素直に聞いちゃうだろうし。
おまじないって なおちゃんみたいな？
なおのはお姉ちゃん専用だけどね。うん、でもそう。
そっかな。
Hearing these words from Nao, I begin to think that might be the case.
あ、わかんないけどね。けど、何にせよ、本人たちが言ってない以上、周りが騒ぐのは良くないんじゃないかなって。いい気しないかもしれないでしょ。
あ。
Nao grins sardonically? The hell kind of word is that?
噂のこと、お姉ちゃんに教えたのはNaoなんだけど、Naoも気をつけなきゃ。
うん。でも、そっか、そうだね。
Having been told this, I think back to how Miss Takeda and Miss Amato had acted. It's true. They didn't seem proud or pleased about what they had done. It wasn't anything like that. And so that's what I decided to do. Yo, I do want to become famous, Daini Euni. Make me famous already.
では、今から20分間自習とします。その後、小テスト。
Pathology class. Edema, humectation, metastasis, angiosarcoma, epithelium, mesenchyme, metastasis, dyskaryosis, structural atapia, deoxybrinucleic...Such difficult words dance across the whiteboard. Amongst our classes, this is considered to be one of the most advanced. Of course, I'm horrible at it. I consider how they'd appeared as pronunciation symbols. She's right. Surprise, surprise. Probably translated as like hiragana.Our time for memorization before our short test begins. Classroom has fallen silent, with the sound of textbook pages turning and pens scribbling across notebooks filling the room. I at least attempt to open my textbook and hammer the words into my head, but...
頑張ろうね、お姉ちゃん。なおちゃん。わかんないところがあったらいつでも聞いて。
Something I don't know. Nao's worried face. I've worried her. I'm a failure as her elder sister. Such meaningless thoughts dance in my head.The former jellyfish club manager, jellyfish-ish me. From the seat next to me, the side that Nao isn't on, someone nudges my shoulder. Held out to me is a folded piece of paper, a letter. The bottom right it says in small letters, Itsuki. Sensing her gaze, I turn my face towards her and my eyes make contact with Miss Amato's.She points towards my hands. She appears to be gesturing for me to read the letter. I carefully open the folded letter.
Osachi Asuka, Shinno Joshi Kōkō Shushin, 4月2日生まれ。血液型 B 型、身長154センチ、体重48キロ。春休みに3キロ増えてこの数字。3サイズ、バスト81。ウエスト63、ヒップ85、合ってる？
何これ
！A list of all my personal information, even my measurements are correct. How does she find this out? I cast a glance towards Miss Amato and see her grinning at me. She points to her eyes and then towards my chest. Does that mean she figured it out just by looking at me? I don't know if I should be impressed or creeped out. Seeking confirmation. Miss Amato makes an okay sign with her fingers. She seems to be asking me if she's right. I furrow my eyebrows and shake my head. I draw a line through where it says 3 kilograms and I write, I only gained 2 before sending back the letter. Letter passes from student to student and before long it is in Miss Amato's hands again. Miss Amato opens the letter and reads it before breaking into a grin. She writes something on a new piece of paper, folds it, and passes it down the row of students until it once again reaches me. I open it. Aggravated at myself for having so easily released top secret information, I bury my heads in my hands. With all that's going on, my test results are dismal, unsurprisingly. That day, there's an announcement from Miss Ohara during the afternoon homeroom. She tells us that tomorrow during basic nursing skills class, we'll be taking a bed-making test. Later that evening, at a somewhat early hour... I mutter. There's no denying that it's difficult, but it's so much more fun than sitting down and studying. It's about 100 times more fun than pathology. I say it just as if I'm going for a casual jog and begin to prepare for my trip to the school. We play at being a fisherman and his wife for a moment, then I leave the dorm. I walk the night road, my feet moving a little faster than usual. Occasionally, I glance up at the night sky. The world of the stars is exasperatingly far. Even now I'm swaying in the waves as I look up at the starry sky. Still a jellyfish girl. How to catch a star? I still don't feel like I'm anywhere close to catching them. On the other hand, I've felt like giving up countless times. Every year amongst nursing students, around the time they advance to the next year, about 10 to 20% of the students drop out. By the time graduation comes along, only about 60% remain. What does this button do down here? Well, I guess it doesn't do anything. It's just part of the aesthetics. I know myself, I'm the type of person who'd fall under the other 40. Even before graduation, there are things like the national qualification examinations. Apparently, now I'd already begun planning for the national exams. Yes, all for the sake of her elder sister. It makes me want to cry. I mutter as I reach my hands out towards the starry sky. I grip my fist and relax it as to see if I've caught a fistful of starlight. There's no sense of reality to my actions. And opening my fist, there is no sign of starlight.
先生みたいな看護師になりたいな。
My words alone are... pardon me. My words alone are grandois. I think such thoughts even though I have no idea of what Miss Ohara was like during her years as a nurse. And yet I'm filled with admiration of her. How she looks in her white uniform. The white-robed angel. I arrive at the school. It's already night, but perhaps because it's still not that late, I can see light coming from some of the windows. The staff room, the library, the hallways, and even the training room.
誰か練習してるのかな?
Although not that late, night is night. It hadn't crossed my mind that anyone other than me would want to practice.
誰だろう?
At the lockers, I change into my training uniform and head to the training room. The door is slightly ajar. Find myself quietly tiptoeing up to the door. I hear voices inside.
はい、私の勝ち。
It's Miss Takeda and Miss Amato. I wonder if it's just the two of them in there. There shouldn't be any problem with me just walking in, but...
だから、私はベッドメイキングの練習は遊びでやるものじゃないと。
あ、終わった後で言うんだ。らしくないね。
だって、それはあなたがしつこく何度も勝負勝負と言うから。いえ、そうね。やめるわ。
切磋琢磨するのは大事。それには競い合わないとね。
うまく言おうとしないで。普通に練習してるのに飽きただけのくせに。
いやあ、飽き性なもんで。
私は別に付き合わなくていいと言ったはずよ。
それはそれで寂しい。部屋で一人なんてさ。
どの口が言っているの?たくさん誘われてるんでしょ?クラスの子から。
おう、ダム。
昨夜以外、眼中にないよ。私は。
I feel dizzy, as if my head were spinning. Another typo. As if my head were spinning. Alright, one second. I'm gonna go make myself another drink and give Princess some of the goodnight kisses. returned. Where's the button? There we go. I feel dizzy, as if my head were spinning. This situation is making it harder for me to walk in. Awkward! But I can't seem to move away from the door either. I seem to have stumbled on quite the scenario. First prize gets a kiss.
何言って勝負ごとにはつきものでしょ?ご褒美。待って、聞いていないわ、そんなことは。あれ?言ってなかったっけ?当たり前だわ。聞いていたらこんな勝負には乗ってな。
Oh shit. See, there's the Yuri nurses. There they are. Both of their voices abruptly stop. Miss Takeda lets out a small gasp as if in surprise. I catch a tiny glimpse through the crack in the door. For a moment, I seem to hear a moan coming from Miss Takeda's lips. By the time I realize it, I've stepped away from the door and rushed off. I can sense myself panicking in my head, yet my thoughts are occupied by the heat rising to my face, and I cannot recall what went through my mind until I've returned to our dorm room. She's still in her uniform. Having lacked the mental capacity to change clothes, the best I had been able to do was take my own clothes out from the locker and dash back to our room. Perhaps due to running, or perhaps due to other reasons, my entire body is hot, and I'm incredibly thirsty. I mean, we knew that already. Wheezing, I managed to gasp out a couple of words. Now quickly brings me a glass of water. I gulp down the entire glass. I sluggishly turn my face towards the questioning now. The image of what I saw is buried in my mind. Oh, my body temperature is rising again. The two of them had been kissing! It appeared that Miss Amato had aggressively initiated the kiss, but Miss Takeda, she didn't seem to be strongly against it either. Her hand on Miss Amato's arm. Her almost audible moan. Her lips. Placing the emptied glass back into Nao's hand, I open my mouth. The two of them had been kissing. A real kiss. Not that I know whether or not there are fake ones. Well-bred girls, distinguished and beautiful. And lovers. I say with a serious expression on my face. The heat's still coursing through my body, and I don't know where I can find an outlet for it. Having made my proclamation, I realize. The first decision I get to make. Do I go back to the school? Or do I get some sleep? Let's see. Let's save on page 5, I guess. Let's go back to the school. Nao advises me against it, but I decide to go back to the academy again. I resolve that I do want to double check my bed making one last time.
It may already be closed.
Please, no.
Just then.
Osachi Asuka-san?
Hey, it's my teacher. Wanna get it on with my sensei.
Ah, Ohara-sensei.
Doushimashita? Gakkou ni wasuremono desu ka?
Ah, ie, etto...
Hmm?
Jishu-shitsu de...
Hearing my words, Miss Ohara looks towards the school building.
Miss Ohara smiles. And so I managed to get a chance to use the training room. My preparation for tomorrow is all set. Plus, I was able to run into Miss Ohara. Luck seems to be on my side. And so... The next day... Hey! We passed the test! Just as I proclaimed last night, I can do it when I set my mind to it. The upbeat music is like... The upbeat music is really loud, but the rest of the music is not. I'm happy, so happy. I love beds. And just like that, my goal has returned. Miss Ohara looks at me as if she doesn't quite comprehend what I mean. Oops. Then, on one particular weekend...
Yeah, Nukeko, dokka o dekake?
I run into Miss Amato in the hallway of our dorm. I hold up the plastic bag containing things I bought at the convenience store. Oh? She says teasingly, before drawing her face close to peek into the bag. Her candid words cause my temper to rise for a moment, but I can't come up with a retort. After all, she's already discovered I gained 2 kilograms thanks to my own stupidity. A couple of dorm students who happen to be passing by call out to her. She answers casually. I realize how popular she is. Seeing Miss Amato's profile as she waves towards the other girls, I suddenly remember...
She's hot! And that she was making out with her friend.
The one I saw in the training room. I ask, thinking it might be a date.
Hime? 違う違う.
Huh?
あれより可愛げのある子だよ. その分...
She speaks notes so nonchalantly. I'm a bit flustered. Is she cheating on her? And so brazenly? Or is Miss Takeda alright with it? Is their relationship just casual? Is this just how rich people do things? Probably nothing to do with it.
Tama no ikinuki ni ne.
She admits her trickery.
I let out a sigh of relief. Thinking about it, it really isn't my place to feel flustered or relieved. But for some reason, I can't really imagine the two of them ever betraying each other. Thinking such thoughts, my body temperature rises a little again. Then a question enters my mind. Something in Miss Amato's words tugs at me. It's not what it seems. Those were the same words she had said on the stairway the first time we met, after my first day of school. She had spoken quietly, as if to keep it a secret from those around us. The other things she said, like, I finally found you, and I'll revise, and I love my girlfriend. There are too many mysteries surrounding Miss Amato, but the biggest mystery of all is this. Why is her hair green? That one takes the cake.
Soda, Amato-san, kite ii?
Nerutoki no kakko? Hadaka da yo?
That's hot.
Oof. Hime ga ne?
Ho ho!
De, so ja nakute!
Spicy!
Atashi mo joudan. Nani?
Hajimete atta toki, itteta yo ne? Uso da yo tte. Are tte douyu imi datta no kana tte?
Miss Amato seems to consider this for a moment. There had seemed to be so much meaning behind those words, and yet she doesn't even remember saying it? I had forgotten as well, so I guess there's no reason to be bothered. I'm not a very honest person, but that time at the training room when she had said to Miss Takeda, I have eyes for no one but you, I felt like she was being honest then. If she's a liar that will only tell the truth when she's with her lover, well, that's actually kinda hot. Anyway. I hear Miss Takeda's voice from far off. She's humming to herself quietly. I look down the hallway and see Miss Takeda exiting her dorm room, unaware of us. Noticing, Miss Amato says, ah, here she is. Don't respond to dummy girl. Miss Amato waves at me and walks away. I nod and begin to head back to my room. I suddenly feel as if I'm being watched, and turn around. Miss Amato is looking at me, a smile playing on the corner of her lips. It's a mischievous smile that seems to be plotting something. Then she softly moves her lips. It's not what it seems. The truth about whether she might be cheating or not, or the fact that she isn't very honest. Maybe she's referring to the nickname Dummy Girl. Nah, I doubt that's the case. I want to ask her, but Miss Amato immediately turns and follows after Miss Takeda. If Nao was here, she would warn me about my language, but Miss Amato's actions are too much of a mystery for me. Most likely, I shouldn't let her words get to me. Deciding not to return to my room, I walk towards the entrance and watch the two of them leave. I can faintly hear Miss Takeda's playful humming. I hadn't known she could be playful like that. It's a little unexpected, honestly. But, well... Miss Takeda is walking by the dormitory with Miss Amato right behind her. They're not walking side by side. Neither are they too close or too far. The distance between them is that of two people who know each other well. They really paint a picture together, I think. No wonder they were chosen as the number one couple in high school for 3 years in a row. Somehow they seem to exist on another plane from me. Now greets me with a smile. Now teases, and I pretend not to have heard. Now smiles. Damn. Nurse love addiction.
はい、それでは今日の看護総合論の授業では。
Next week, we have our first group work in class.
Group work とはただ集団で学習するだけではなく、看護師として必要なコミュニケーション能力を高めることを目的としています。
What the hell? Sorry, I'm doing something on another monitor.
これは患者さんとの会話だけでなく、病院での他の看護師や医師といった方々との対話能力も指しています。なので、自分の考えをはっきりと伝えながら、相手の話もよく聞き、議論を深めていってください。
Miss O'Hara continues.
それと、これから行うグループ分けのメンバーで、夏休み前に行われる病院実習にも行ってもらいます。チームワーク、育んでくださいね。
She smiles as she gives us this important information. Training amongst real nurses at a real hospital. For us nursing students, this will be the most valuable experience we could have. There is the possibility that all the nurses would collapse and we would be left to protect the patients. Yeah, that probably won't be happening. Even so, the jellyfish-ish part of me drifts in this daydream, causing my excitement to grow. After all, this is the workplace of my dreams. Literally. Well, in any case, teamwork between group members will be really important.
では、グループを発表します。
大事って。よろしくね。
マチンミチ。
よろしく。お姉ちゃんともどもよろしくお願いします。
やろ。
よろしくお願いするわ。
And so these are the six members of our group. You can feel the gazes of people from the other groups. They're envious-ish. But seriously, come on!
では、今日のグループワークの課題は、心意交換です。患者さんにとってどんな意味があるのか、効率よく行うポイントは何か、など話し合ってくださいね。次の授業で発表してもらいますから、実習室を使って実際に練習もして意見をまとめるように。
Saying this, Miss O'Hara leaves the rest to us students. Machi Tatsumi and Michi Tori seem friendly enough. It appears they are already friends and seem happy to be in the group. Other than that, there's Miss Takeda, who seems to hate me, and Miss Amato, who's a complete mystery to me. Handling the both of them would probably be difficult, even for now. So yes, as the elder sister, I'll take the initiative and lead.
するしかない。
I shoot my hand up in the air.
じゃあ、自己紹介からしてみるとかかな。
必要ないでしょ。もうみんな顔と名前は一致しているはずよ。
だよね。
I received the counter punch full on. Miss Amato is grinning. Now offers tactfully. Good job, now. Another video game reference. Cause she's a gamer! Oh my god! How relatable! The best girl is a gamer!
Game の話でしょ?昨夜も遅くまでやっていたようだし。仮ゲーより RPG 派。
知らんがな。
黙りなさい。そうね。私も自分のことから話すのに賛成だわ。
私も。
As if to confirm how well they get along, Miss Tatsumi and Miss Tori speak in unison.
よかった。
I love this like lazy way of explaining the two side characters, like...
Within the group, I see the invisible now stocks rising. Speaking of stocks rising, I gotta check my SHIB coin. It's been holding at like 7 for the last couple of days, which is pretty insane. And it's still about there, and hovering like between 6, 7, 7, 0, 7, 4. Yeah, it's fine. It's fine right now. I let out a small grunt.
Yeah, yeah, 偶然。私もそう言おうと思ってたんだ。先越されちゃったな。
Shut up, Asuka. Sheesh coin? Sheesh coin? Nah, I'm, throwing all my money into a undead sheep coin. It's my bad habit that I say things I shouldn't at times like this. She glares at me. Eek!
自分が眠る時の格好ね。
A look of contemplation crosses Miss Takeda's face. Remembering Miss Amato's words, I panic slightly, even though I know she had been joking. Perhaps noticing me acting oddly, Miss Takeda asks me suspiciously. She just say, you know, your friend over there said you sleep in the nude. Both Nao and I ask in unison. We are both Miss Osachi, after all. Miss Takeda realizes this.
So ne. Shimai nano da kara. Kore ja dochira ka wakaranai wa ne.
She looks thoughtful for a moment.
Asuka.
My heart lets out a small leap just by hearing her say my first name. No honorifics, god. Wow, we're moving fast, okay. We get married next week, huh?
じゃあ、私もいつきで。さくやちゃん。
いつきちゃん。
ちゃんはやめて。
Miss Takeda narrows her eyebrows. Does she consider nicknames to be childish? Perhaps sensing the tension, or completely unaware of it, Nao blurts this out suddenly. Well played. So, what should I call Miss Takeda?
Sakuya-ka.
I'm just gonna call her Sakuya.
Kuri?
Well, she's saying that it's alright.
Sakuya-san, Itsuki-san, Nao-chan.
Nao grins, seeming oddly happy about something. Miss Takeda seems a little dissatisfied about the miss thing, but she says nothing. After all, she has her aura of being above earthly concerns to think about. As for Miss Tatsumi and Miss Tori...
私たちもちゃんでいいよ!
Once again, they speak in unison, and so ultimately we decide to call them with just their first names. Miss Takara, now to be called Sakia, speaks up once again.
That's cute.
Oh-ho! I'll say, personally, sleeping naked kinda sucks. Cause like, you know, as a dude, your junk is just like hanging out there, and it's not very comfortable. Like, wearing boxer briefs is much more comfortable. Like, I don't sleep with a shirt on, because if I sleep with a shirt on, then my collar will, like, I'll wake up really sweaty around my neck, and that's nasty. But I can sleep with pants on, and I sleep with, like, even when I'm hot as hell, I'll sleep with underwear on, because I don't like my junk just kind of flopping around. Like, I like having it contained. Why are you pacing, Bear? What's the matter? We took you on two walks today. What's the matter, bub? What's up? Response to Miss Itsuki's words, Machi and Michi let out squeals of delight. Well, they're giving her the response she wants. In such a way, we talk about our nightwear and what we would do if we were hospitalized. Yeah, like I said, I don't sleep with a shirt on. Like, if I'm super cold, I'll sleep with a hoodie, because that's a lot looser, and, you know, it's easier to rip off. What's up? How you doing, Bear? If I had face cam on, I'd just have, like, the camera pointing at the dog. When you stretch, that means you want something, and I don't know what you want from me. Because it's way too late for going out. A sigh escapes Miss Sakia's lips. I've grown used to her exasperation with me. Miss Sakia suddenly raises the bar for us with her statement. Once again, Miss Itsuki seems to be making references to gaming.
Then, Asuka, you from?
Yeah!
Why are you surprised? What do you think about the new point?
Now quietly sends me a few words of encouragement. Pajamas. What to pay attention to when changing the patient's pajamas? It must be important to think of it from the patient's perspective. If I were a patient, what would make me happy? Alright. Miss Sakia responds coldly. Everyone seems to agree with this assessment. Machi and Michi are nodding. Hey, aren't you two a little too easily swayed?
But,
褒めてあげると喜んで気持ちよく応じてもらえるんじゃないかな。だからナオはお姉ちゃんの意見いいなって思う。
Of course you would think your sister is smart even though she's a dummy. Now support.
ありがてえ。
Incidentally, the points for changing nightwear mentioned in the textbook are a consideration of the patient's privacy and careful monitoring of the temperature of the room. Nowhere do they mention complimenting the patient for having adorable pajamas. Even after that, whenever I would say anything, Miss Sakia would sternly point out the flaws in my argument. Even during our group practice at the training room, this continued. And continued. After school, I walk through the hallway like a zombie or a ghost.
Osachi-san?
From behind, I hear Miss Ohara's voice.
Sensei!
どうしました?元気がないようですけど、グループ練習で疲れましたか?
はい。っていうか、主に心が。
I swallow my words. Miss Ohara watches me blankly. Miss Ohara, the white-robed angel, the nurse that I want to be just like. I don't want someone like that to see me now in my worn-out state. I look so uncool. But was there ever a time that I was cool? Probably not.
Group work, うまくいかなかったんですか?
I shake my head ruefully.
ダメダメでした。
I laugh and Miss Ohara smiles gently.
まだ始まったばかりです。少しずつ進めばいいと思いますよ。
そうですか。
ええ、大幸さんはいい伸びしろを持っていると先生は思っていますから。
Miss Ohara's words warm my heart a little.
私、成長できるのかな?
できます。しっかり頑張れば。
看護師になれるのかな?
なれます。きっと。
ナイチンゲール賞、取れるのかな?
取れま。え?
Miss Ohara looks surprised and a little amused. I stare at her. Miss Ohara says,
頑張りましょう、大幸さん。
Damn!No confidence. I nod. Then I make my confession for the first time.
私、先生が目標なんです。先生みたいな看護師になりたいって。
The next second. Huh? Miss Ohara's expression seems to change for a split second, as if she were suppressing pain.
私なんて、目指すほどじゃないですよ。
Perhaps in response to my confusion, Miss Ohara explains gently.
これから大幸さんは病院実習でたくさんの看護師と会います。その中には先生より目標にするにふさわしい先輩看護師がいくらでもいるっていうそういう話です。もちろん先生も精一杯協力しますけどね。
Miss Ohara's words help me better comprehend her meaning. However, I decide it's for the best to not tell her that, as far as I'm concerned, she'll always be my role model.
ありがとう、先生。元気出ました。
はい。では、また明日。
She grins. Flashing her angelic smile, Miss Ohara walks away. Watching her from behind, I decide my best to try to follow in her footsteps.Somewhere from within Miss Ohara's clothes, an envelope falls and flutters to the floor in front of my feet. 6 out of 7 runs from homers. Nice. Are you gonna go to the parades that will inevitably be happening? Pick it up and read the words on the front.
辞職願い?
Oh!
何でもありません!
Oh! she moves with lightning speed. Right after, or perhaps even as I read the words, Miss Ohara, who had walked away, appears in front of me again in a split second. She quickly takes back the envelope I had picked up. Huh? I don't understand what's going on.
Letter of resignation? Resignation. A declaration of her intent to quit her job. Her job as a nursing teacher.
Sensei, yameru no?
Even as I cannot seem to fully grasp this situation, I feel my eyes begin to burn.
Chigaimasu.
Miss Ohara firmly denies the suggestion.
Demo sorete.
Miss Ohara appears to want to put it away in her breast pocket immediately. But, as if resigning herself to the fact that I have seen it, she continued to hold the envelope in her hands. As I remain unable to say anything further, all I can do is feel my vision beginning to blur. I remain unable to do anything but gaze at Miss Ohara with watering eyes. A small sound escapes her lips. Oh my god.
それだけなんです。それ以外の何物でもないんです。私のものじゃないんです。だから気にしないでください。 誰のだろうこれ? 名前書いてないからわかんないですね。困った困った。だから他の誰にもこのことは言わないでください。
Miss Ohara smiles. I remain in a daze. Miss Ohara smiles and smiles and smiles, but all at once I feel a bulldozer-like rush of pressure from her. Alright, this is definitely a part where I need to save. I think I put the pressure on her. I don't remember what I have to do to go down her route, but I feel like if I wanted to go down her route, I would say, okay, I won't. But if I were, like, if I were in this situation, I'd be like, what would you do if I told someone? I think I'll try to keep her trust. Miss Ohara's relief is palpable. I feel almost as if I could touch it with my hands. Not fully understanding what's going on, in the end, there's only one thing I want to confirm. In response to my words, Miss Ohara says,
Hi.
There seems to be both laughter and something close to tears in her expression. You okay over there? It's hot. You're sweaty. Oh yeah, you are warm. What the hell was that?
My nose
was... Sounded like you were growling at me. One day, at the end of May... Now, whom I usually always go home with after school, comes to me. An anatomic physiology teacher. During high school, Nao's popularity with the teachers was a stuff of legend. During high school, according to stories, it caused teachers to fight over her in the staff room. She was also popular with the older students, I recall. I slapped my bag to show her. Yeah, slap at the bag! Outside the window, I can see clouds have gathered. It looks like it might rain at any time, even though it's still a little early for rainy season. Saying this, I step out of the classroom first. Turn around and see that Nao is watching me with a reluctant and somewhat lonely expression on her face. I laugh and wave my hand to show her it's alright. By the time I walk from the classroom to the entrance, it has already started to rain. And with quite some force. There seems to be wind as well, and the sky appears restless. Not that I meant it metaphorically, but speak of the devil. Miss Saki is standing there at the front entrance, and my mind makes a mean little connection. I told her she'd get angry for sure. I'll keep it a secret. Miss Saki glances over at me for only a second before looking forward again. She spreads open the umbrella in her hand, and not paying any heed to me, walks off into the rain. Miss Saki is on her own as well. Miss Itsuki, whom she always goes home with, isn't here today. But I guess things like that happen. I don't give it much thought as I take the fold-up umbrella out of my bag and open it. A small yawn escapes my lips. Recently, I haven't been sleeping much. Of course this is, due to studying. It's 100% all of my studying. After all, I have my own live-in tutor in Nao. Saying this, I step out into the rain. A harsh wind blows and carries my umbrella away from my grasp, sending it floating into the air. Lands on the road in front of the school. A truck rushes across, running it over. Rippin' pussy, umbrella. I stare in a stunned daze. The hard rain falls at an angle. I stand there for a while. What just happened? Just then, I hear Misakiya's accusing voice. Misakiya walks over towards me, then, grabbing me, pulls me under the umbrella. For a second, I don't understand what she means. A small sigh escapes her lips. We're sharing an umbrella. What an extraordinary turn of events. Easily accept the offer. Deciding to take advantage of her offer, I bow my head deeply. She narrows her eyebrows. Is she blushing?
もっとく。いや、助かったです。ありがとう。放っておけなかっただけよ。アスカ、もっとこっちに寄りなさい。でも、もう結構濡れちゃってるし、酔ったら咲夜さんまで。
Prompted by Miss Saki, I draw closer to her. Our arms touch. For a while, we walk in silence. Miss Saki has to try to force conversation. The only sounds that enter my ears are the rain pounding on the umbrella and the occasional car driving by. Alone with Miss Saki and at such close distance, walking next to each other, in silence. The girl who, even if she doesn't hate me, yowza! Yo, you guys missed the Yuri! You're way too late, guys. Come on, you already missed the girl's kissing scene. But you are just in time for the sharing an umbrella scene, so I guess this is fine too. What's up, Cubelets? How was your stream? What were you doing? I hope you had a great time. Let me give you a shout out here. Blitz with two Z's. You were playing Just Chatting. Sounds good. The girl who, even if she doesn't hate me, doesn't particularly like me. Just chatting with the fans, understandable. So the story thus far is we are a nursing student. We are the pink-haired girl right here. This girl is a Hime Dere. She's adorable. She has a magical power called Healing Hands that stopped a little girl from crying after she hurt herself.
Garuga Mash!
Oh, yeah!
Thank you for the follow, Cold Snap 77. Great magic set. And, my umbrella got run over by a car, so now we are sharing an umbrella as we walk back to the dormitory. I should be nervous.
なんでだろう?
全然平気。平気?何が?
In response to my whisper, Sakia asks this suspiciously. I shake my head from side to side.
何でもないよ。今日は一緒じゃないんだね。
Miss Itsuki really is popular. She had also been approached that time at our dorm. But Miss Sakia doesn't seem to be worried at all. I guess they trust each other. They are lovers after all.
Sakuya-san, 髪からいい香りがする。
Nursing students are discouraged from wearing perfumes or strong-smelling cosmetics. Apparently, it doesn't matter much when you're a student, but when you're a nurse and you interact with patients, it's not very good manners to have a strong scent. That was actually something one of my viewers was mentioning just a few days ago, that wearing strong perfumes or deodorants is seen as, like, rude because you don't want to smell too strongly. So Miss Sakia doesn't seem to be using anything like that, but her hair still has a rich, intoxicating fragrance. Since she's a high-class girl, I think about how she probably uses really good shampoo. Speaking of which, I need to wash my hair. I didn't wash it today because usually you're only supposed to wash it like once a week or once every week and a half. Because you want to let the natural oils seep into it and really, you know, let your hair grow and be nice.
勉強テスト、レポート。そうね。医師とは違うけれど、私たちも患者の命を預かることがある仕事だから、慢性的に看護師の数は不足しているけれど、だからといって基準を緩くすることもできない。なるほど。なんだか真剣味が足りないわね、あなたは。
And so I tell her about the career aptitude survey, about the picture book, and about the scribbling on the last page.
そういうことって、咲夜さんもある? Sakuya-san?
ごめんなさい. そうね. 私はないけれど, 確かに人によってはありそうだわ.
Needless to say, this girl here that we're talking to is one of the romantic interests we can pursue.
でも,
and Keith.
でも?
そこから本当にその夢を追おうというのは珍しいと思うわ.
なんか、私変人みたい.
そう言ったのよ.
Damn.
There's a composed expression on Miss Sakia's face. With the sound of the rain around us, there's something comforting about us conversing like this.
Sakuya-san wa? Sore ga watashi no subeki koto na no da. Tte itteta kedo.
Wow. Thank you for the 100 bits, my man, and you only just followed? You're too kind.
I see you like Yuri.
The reason why I'm, the current game I'm playing, Nurse Love Addiction, is the sequel to a game that I played last year called a Nurse Love Syndrome, and it's not a direct sequel. It is a sequel in the sense that it is in the same world, but with a different cast of characters. So, I really like this game. I played it before, which is why I've played the prequel on stream. And I never played this game on stream, so that's why I'm deciding to play it now. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Already beat you to it, Benish.
それだけでもないけれど、そういうことよ。
Feel a sense of admiration for her. I turn my gaze ahead of us. Beyond the confines of our umbrella, I can see the rain clouds. The girl who chased stars. Perhaps my next words are because I had to talk. I had talked about the world of stars in my picture book.
Excuse me. 今夜は星が見えそうにないね。そうね。残念だわ。
残念って、あ、サクヤさん星を見るのが好きなの？
嫌いではないわね。というか、星を見るのが嫌いな人はそういないでしょ。
うん、確かに。
アスカは星を見るのが好きなの？
Mm. That's something to consider. I just recently moved to Texas from New Jersey, and I'm wondering how that will affect the night sky that we see. I mean, it won't be too much, because we're still on the northern hemisphere. But still, gotta consider that.
好きだけど、あまり見ないかな。
それは不思議ね。どうしてかしら？
いや、だって、見ると、うわ、遠いなーって思っちゃって。
ああ、それはわかるわ。
本当？
でも、それは普通のことよ。
そうだけど。
With a somewhat gloomy expression on my face, I look at Miss Sakia. Her face is composed as always. I can't help but think how beautiful she is. A star. That small star that I saw when I first met her. What had that been? Part of me wants to ask her, while another part thinks now is not the right time. We arrive at our dorm.
Arigato.
Zuibun nurete iru wa. Hayaku heya de kigae nasai.
Un, so suru.
Parting ways, I head to my room. Miss Saki and Miss Itsuki's room is on a floor above ours, so she walks to the stairs and I walk over to in front of my door. Usually I leave locking and unlocking the door to now, so now I go to pull out my key that has hardly seen any use. I go to pull it out, but...
あれ?あれ?ここの小さなポケットに…あれ?
It's not there. It's not in the place that it's supposed to be. Did I drop it somewhere? Did I leave it in our room? When was the last time I used it?
全然覚えてない。
Stupid me for relying so much on now. What should I do? Just as I consider how this is a case of my chickens coming home to roost.
何をしているの?
I'm a little distance off, near the front of the stairs. I hear Miss Sakia's voice, perfectly and completely exasperated. That makes two of us. And so...
She's got a little anime figure up there.
I hesitantly enter. In this manner, I step into Miss Sakia and Miss Itsuki's room. Once again, stating that she can't abandon me, I'm invited by Miss Sakia, or more accurately, I'm ordered by her to enter their room to dry myself. As we live in the same dorm, the basic structure of the room is the same as ours, but of course, since it's someone else's room, the feel is much different. It may just be my imagination, but there seems to be a scent of opulence in the air. Time to practice changing each other's clothes! Oh, there's also a gaming console. Feeling bad about stepping into the room with wet feet, I stand near the entrance. Well, she's telling me to take off my clothes, I guess I have to. Saying this, Miss Sakia brings her own bath towel along with an extra one. She holds it out to me. I take it. The bath towel seems to be of high quality. The moment I hold it, I can feel the difference in texture from my towel. My towel's from Walmart. I look and see that Miss Sakia has begun to swiftly undress. My presence does not seem to bother her in the slightest. I guess that's understandable. I begin to remove my clothes. I consider what to do with the clothes I remove, but just decide to let them fall to my feet for now. Dry my body with the bath towel. Its absorption qualities are amazing. I want it. That's me with hotel towels. Because, like, hotel beds? Not something to write home about, but a towel in a hotel room? That thing is so absorbent. Like, you take a shower, you wipe yourself off, and you're dry. There's just no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Most likely, it'll cost me an arm and a leg. As I dry my body, I cast a glance towards Miss Sakuya, the outline of her body in profile, her breathtakingly white skin. What can I say? I can't help myself from admiring. The accusation in Miss Sakuya's voice brings me back to myself. I tell her with heartfelt admiration. Her cheeks flush slightly and she puts on her nightwear as if to quickly hide her skin. I hope she's not too wary of me now. Ah ha ha, her lacy nightgown. Oh, it's cute! Having her lend me her clothes seems to be going a little too far. Misakiya says this as if to scold me. Then she walks over to her closet. I wait where I stand, somehow feeling jittery. Then she opens the closet door and takes out a single shirt. She walks over to me as I stand near the entrance and holds out the shirt to me. It's a thin, classy blouse. It must belong to Miss Sakuya. Saying this, she thrusts it out to me. I take a step forward and reach out my hand. I feel cold sensation beneath my feet. It's my wet clothes that I had dropped onto my floor. My jacket. Oops, I slipped and fell and grabbed your boobies. I'm slipping. My feet are slipping. Losing my balance, I use all the strength in my feet to try to stop myself. It had the opposite effect. I end up kicking my wet jacket into the air with my foot and my body falls forward into Miss Sakia's arms. I fall. She goes eek. Clutching onto each other, we tumble to the floor. And I grab her boobies! Yeah! Hitting my hip, for a moment I feel a throbbing pain, but such thoughts quickly flee my mind. When I realize it, her face is at an incredibly close distance to mine. I swallow nervously. I find myself lying completely on top of her, as if I had pushed her down. We're so close, I can see my own reflection in her eyes. I can hear her breathing. It's so close, I can almost touch it. For a short moment, I can't think of anything.
My mind is blank, as if I had been shot out into outer space. Weightless? I can reach out my hand. No. I don't know how long I remained like that, but suddenly I returned to my senses. Then, even as I think this, I begin to comprehend my situation. With all my strength, I've pushed down Miss Sakia, and I'm continuing to hold her down. Not only that, it appears as I'm trying to force her to kiss me. It's an unfortunate accident, but of course I doubt there's any way Miss Sakia will forgive me. Will she kill me? Panic. Miss Sakia's mouth begins to make small movements. I can't hear what she's saying at all. A scolding? Verbal abuse? A death sentence? Then, for some reason, a translucent expression appears on her face.
Oh, she's okay with it.
I feel a slight sense of nostalgia. My body is freed from its rigor in response to Miss Sakia's words, and I try to separate our bodies. Simultaneously, there's the sound of the door opening, and who else would choose this moment to enter but... Her voice is immediately amused. To make matters worse... Enter now! Why? Miss Sakia seems completely calm. Impressive as always. What a grown-up. No, this is a misunderstanding. I've been caught red-handed! Afterwards, returning to our room. From the start, it appears Nao had basically understood what had happened with a single glance. As for my key, it had fallen onto the floor near the side of our beds. That's all you get for now, Liddy. Nao goes to the kitchen. It all makes sense now. Nao talks as she boils water. And so, as we wait for the tea to finish, we let time pass with Nao talking about Miss Itsuki and me talking about Miss Sakia and how soft her boobies were. The warm tea works amazingly on my cold body. June. The rainy season is a dreary time. Light rain falls outside the window.
ですので、血圧測定は毎日行うのが理想的です。特に入院している患者さんの血圧を含めたバイタルを毎日測定するのは基本中の基本で。
It happens during our class on blood pressure measurement in the training room. To be honest, I'm fed up. The onset of a headache, it's still alright, but I can feel it probably begin around the end of class. I consider how long I have had this problem. These light headaches that come every year during the rainy season. I've heard stories about how it has something to do with the change in the barometric pressure.
帰ったら、なおちゃんにおまじないしてもらおう。
I could totally relate, though. When the seasons change, I usually get a pretty, nasty cold. The healing forehead we had talked about once while we were in bed. Remembering this, I laughed slightly. Now, who had gone on to Miss Ohara to ask a question, looks at me and cocks her head.
O-ne-chan?
I shake my head to tell her that it's nothing.
Tutsu? Serudoi.
One-chan, makase nasai. Except it's Imoto. I was quoting, because I have my Gojima wa Usagi desu ka figures next to me, and that's what Koko says a lot. Now, also lets out a small laugh. The rainy season is gloomy, and I dislike headaches, but I like having Nao do her magic charm on me. Nao is my miracle drug. First time I said that to Nao was a very long time ago. Even with my bad memory, I remember it clearly. I won't forget that precious moment.
Itsuki, soko, mou skoshi kitsume ni.
Ko?
Sore de wa kitsu sugiru wa. State ga hairu sukima nai de shou?
Miss Saki and Miss Itsuki are practicing on a s- How do I fucking pronounce this word? Sphygmomanometer. I remember I had to do- hold on. What the fuck is this?
Sphygmomanometer.
What the fuck? It just drops that word. Oh my god. Miss Saki and Miss Itsuki are practicing on a sphygmomanometer separate to ours. It's the thing, like, you know the thing that they wrap around your arm to take your blood pressure? That's a sphygmomanometer, apparently. Ever since that day, I find my eyes following Miss Sakia unconsciously. Drizzling rain falls outside the window, its sound not reaching inside the classroom. And so the sound of rain in my head is that of the day I had walked home with Miss Sakia. Yeah, you get it, lady.
なんて思って測定している患者さんもいるかもしれません。しかし、そういう方にはなぜ必要なのかをきちんと説明して理解していただけるようにしてくださいね。Miss
Ohara's voice wafts through the classroom like peaceful music.
先生は先生やめない。
Since then, Miss Ohara has shown no sign of acting different.
Futo, dou natta no kana?
Futo.
Sore dewa, Nao-chan.
After school, we've returned to our room. The ceremony for the magic charm begins with us sitting on our knees, facing each other. I first sit on my knees on the floor and wait for Nao. The room is quiet. My head throbs slightly. The rain has grown stronger, and even in our room, you can hear it softly now.
Nao,
who had been washing dishes in the kitchen, wipes her hands and walks on over. Saying this, Nao sits on her knees so close to me that our kneecaps are basically touching. I make this dramatic pronouncement and bow my head. Now let's out a small laugh.
だろうね。
そうだね。1年に2、3回じゃ済まなかった年もあるし。
ね。
Now speaks in a low voice that has a slightly mischievous ring to it.
なに、なおちゃん。
たまには違う姿勢でしてみよっか。
She wants to try a different position, you know what that means. Even as she says this, Now takes my hands and pulls me towards herself. Slowly, she falls onto her back. Oh. With my hands being pulled, I fall forward until naturally. I end up in a position where I could be said to be covering or pinning down Now as she lies on the floor.
Nao-chan.
She is under my body. She looks up at me. The look in her eyes suggests she wants to say something. Although the magic charm hasn't even started yet, for a moment I forget all about my headache. I can feel Now's body heat where our skin touches. Now's body temperature has always been higher than mine, and so, apparently, summer has never been her favorite season. Huh? Maybe body temperature didn't have anything to do with it. She opens her mouth. Of course, it doesn't make me feel unpleasant in any way. Now lets out a small laugh. For some reason, Now's eyes seem slightly moist. Do I kiss my sister? I know what you want. Yeah, I know what the crowd wants. I know what the crowd wants. I think this as if my consciousness were being sucked away to somewhere else. After all, no part of me resists the idea of kissing my sister. Now's hand reaches out towards my head, as if to examine the headache, as if to embrace my head. Now's hand touches my hair and it tickles slightly. There's a static energy between the two of us, almost like something magnetic. Then Now says, her hand moved towards the tip of my nose and her index finger prods my nose up slightly. I'm now sporting a piggy nose. Now lets out a giggle. How are you gonna fucking blue ball us like that? Are you kidding me? Speaking playfully, she sits up. Huh? Dazed, I follow her lead and sit up as well. Scam! As she says this, Now has already returned to her usual self. Obediently, I extend my forehead towards my sister. Now also leans her body forward and brings her forehead towards mine. Our foreheads touch. I close my eyes. I can hear the sound of rain again, and her voice. Now's voice as she says the magic charm. Thinking such thoughts, I've had a hard time concentrating on the spell, but it's still just as effective. Now has done it again. Whenever I need it, she is my miracle drug. After the magic charm finishes, I mutter these words, and Now grins.
Sweet-o-shista.
She's wearing a choker. Sweet? Don't I know it. Now serves us homemade panna cotta for our afternoon snack. She said she made it in 5 minutes, but I'm impressed by the quality. It's sweet and...
なるほど。なおちゃん味。
It makes sense. I am impressed.
She blushes slightly.
I wish I knew what she said there.
That day, a storm comes.
Oh no!
The weather outside was frightful.
No, I'm a little too early for that.
How's kickball, Safari guy? You missed the Flyers winning, and apparently the Braves won the World Series, too.
The storm is caused by Miss Ohata's words at school, in the training room.
Bed pan training?
Murmurs course throughout the classroom. There was even something like a cry of dismay.
Truly a storm.
We lost the game on the field, won the Flip Cup social point. Okay, yeah, Flip Cup? Understandable. I'm a master of Flip Cup. It's a shame we didn't play this weekend, though.
看護師にとってその解除や後始末も大事な仕事ですから。患者さんの心理や実際のところを知るために、今日は皆さんに症状排泄を体験してもらいますね。Miss
Ohara flashes her angelic smile.
ベッドの中で。それでは皆さん、準備始めましょうか。And
in an environment where our classmates are close by. I cry out faintly in a stunned voice.
Alright,
time to piss in front of everybody.
Miss Sakia mutters in a very serious voice.
それとこれは違うわ。周りにクラスメートがいる中で行うのはさすがに。そんなもんかね。何?あなたは平気なの?とりあえず、夕べメトレ100回やって慣れたつもり。それなら私もしたわ。
And so we receive an explanation of exactly how the training will go down. It turns out we won't actually have to be peeing in a bed with our classmates watching. What a relief. The curtains of each individual bed will be closed and the student will lie down on the bed alone. Then, removing their underwear, they'll place the bedpan between their legs. And then they let it flow. What if you don't gotta pee? Designated by Miss Ohara, there's nowhere for me to run. All you gotta do is pee. I don't know, last time I tried to pee in front of other people, I couldn't do it. And it was weird, because like, I was at a concert, and I really had to go, but me and my stepbrother basically snuck into the floor seats amongst a group of people because, you know, he had to have a wristband to get into the floor seats. We snuck in and the bathrooms were outside, so we couldn't leave. So I tried to go in a water bottle. Like, you know, I stuck it up the pant leg, aimed it correctly, and I tried to go, but I just, like, I'm standing there, I'm trying to let it loose, and I'm like, it's not coming out. I'm getting stage fright here. So, like, you know, what if they get stage fright or something, you know? Alright. Receiving this form of encouragement from Nao, I awkwardly pass the curtain and walk to the bed. I lie down.
Relax.
何にも考えずにただおしっこすればいいだけなんだから。って無理です。カーテンで見られてないってもちょろちょろって音周りに聞こえたりするかもしれないし、おなら出ちゃったらとか考えるとそもそも全然力抜けないし。
You can't fart in front of your classmates. Around me, the training room is not buzzing with voices, but there is an odd tension in the air.
しなきゃ、おしっこしなきゃ。
The more I think that I need to, the less I can. Time continues to pass and I can hear the voices from the other beds of those who finished. Voices saying things like, that was tiring and it's emotionally draining, but they've finished and are moving on to the next students.
私も早くしなきゃ。
そこ、隣のベッドが空きましたね。武田さん、そちらを使ってください。
はい、先生。
I hear Miss Sakia's voice. It's because I'm taking forever.
毎日してることなのに。
I had no idea that just by the environment changing, it could become so difficult. In the end, I cannot bring myself to pee. And Miss Ohara says,
そこのベッド、時間かかりすぎです。大札さん、交代してください。
Hearing that voice, I get out of the bed. Don't forget to put your underwear back on.Stepping out from the curtain, I see that Miss Sakia has already finished and returned. Maybe all her visualization had worked. Now is also standing there with a worried look on her face. I smile in an attempt to hide my blushes.
Yeah, やっぱ無理だよ。ベッドっておしっこする場所じゃないもんね。
できなかった人も、患者さんはそれくらい抵抗を感じることもある行為だということを覚えてくださいね。
だそうよ。
はい。
On one fair-weathered weekend during the rainy season...
お、いつきさんだ。え？
Now and I had gone near the station to shop. When we arrive back at the dormitory, we see her there. She's standing a little inside the thicket near the dormitory.Miss Itsuki appears to be talking to someone on her smartphone. Sumafo. There's an expression on her face that I have never seen before. Serious? Grave? I can't hear what she's saying from where we're standing. I wonder who she's talking to. Miss Itsuki notices our presence and says something into her smartphone before ending the call. She raises one of her hands and approaches us from the thicket.
や、大札姉妹、今の見てた？
うん、電話してたんだ。
そ、ちょっとね。姫には聞かれたくない内緒の話。
Princess refers to Miss Sakuya. She says this meaningfully, but I can't take her at face value. After all, this is Miss Itsuki that we're talking about.
二人とも聞いてた？
ここまで聞こえないよ。距離あるもん。
そっか、それよかった。
よかった？
もし聞かれてたら、あんたたちをあれしなきゃいけないところだったのさ。
あれって？何あれって？
あれはあれだよ。あれを何してそれするんだ。やばい相手との電話なんでね。
ひえ。お姉ちゃん、いつきさんも、そういうのはダメだよ。
おっと。
Now breaks the tension. Miss Itsuki shrugs her shoulders apologetically.
まあ、ただのダチよ。ちょっと揉めてさ。
She says as if the topic no longer interests her. The end of June. I'm relieved upon hearing on the TV that this year the rainy season will end earlier than last year. On one particular day...I first notice it during the morning basic nursing skills training.
お姉ちゃん、どうしたの？
I shake my head to say that it's nothing, but... It continued,
even into the afternoon. Going home, I walked next to my sister. I abruptly stopped walking. I spin around to look behind me, then I continue to eye my surroundings. Now looks surprised. I flap my hands as if to wave off the notion. It's true, though, that for a while I've had the sense that someone has been watching me closely. If I told this to most people, they would say I'm just imagining things, but... Not now. She lowers her voice with a worried expression on her face. A stalker? Even though a similar thought had crossed my mind, I hadn't been able to say the word. I thought going there would be overthinking things. You consider how they probably have passionate fans, especially Miss Itsuki. Now suddenly raises her voice, frightening me. Damn. I blush slightly. Whoa, wait a minute. Now is suddenly acting stubborn. From what I remember, this wasn't what we originally were talking about, but in any case, it takes quite some time to restore Nao's mood. In the end, for some reason, I've even promised her that we'll sleep in the same bed tonight. Nao is smiling with satisfaction, and I'm not entirely sure how things ended up this way. Even as this goes on, the entire time I continue to feel as if someone is watching me from somewhere. We return to our dorm. Later that night. Tonight there's such a beautiful starry sky.
Ooh.
Stew? Delicious. Yeah, carrots. How do you hate carrots? I mean, you know, if the carrots aren't cooked, then I can understand that. But cooked carrots, they're like nice and soft and squishy and flavorful. Like, how do you hate carrots in a stew? Like, Nao laughs dryly in response to the declaration of my hatred for vegetables. Nao's words abruptly finish at an odd point, huh? And then... Saying this, she points outside the window. Nao asks me if she wants me to go with her, but I tell her it's alright. I step out alone to the front of the dorm. I recognize who it is immediately. In the shadow of the electricity pole, dressed in a white uniform, she's crouching down as if to hide herself, but doing a horrible job of it. Nao said she felt someone was watching our room, but that's an understatement of how sharp she'd been. I clear my throat quietly, drum up my courage, and call out to her. I forgot about this. In a strangled voice of surprise, the person wearing the white uniform spins around towards me. Why is she wearing her white uniform? For a moment, such puzzling thoughts crossed my mind.
This is
so goofy. Miss Ohara gives me a smile. Her angelic smile. It's most definitely Miss Ohara who's there, wearing her white uniform, a nurse's cap, and her smile. I'm filled with admiration for this ideal nurse standing in front of me. Putting aside the fact that she's hiding suspiciously in the shadow of an electricity pole near our dorm. But not even I can put that aside. Miss Ohara spins around and attempts to walk off. What is she doing here? And at this time of night? Then, even with my horrible memory, I recall what might make Miss Ohara so interested in what I was doing. In her surprise, Miss Ohara nearly topples over. Oops. What a dummy. What an absolute blunder. I've come to the roof of the academy with Miss Ohara. The lights of the city, the closeness of the sky. Miss Ohara says my name and I turn around. I felt a little awkward talking in front of my dorm, so I told Miss Ohara that we should talk somewhere private. She had brought me here. Miss Ohara seems fidgety. I'm filled with questions such as why she's wearing her uniform. But right now, there are more important matters. The envelope from that day, the one that had the letter of resignation written on it, and which she had told me not to tell anyone about. The envelope that belongs to someone who isn't Miss Ohara, as we had both agreed to believe. That's the only thing I could think of that might be worrying Miss Ohara. But I do feel a little sad. After all, this means that she hadn't trusted me when I had promised her I wouldn't tell anyone. Miss Ohara nods, but her expression seems to say otherwise. She does not seem convinced. It had been 3 weeks since I made that promise to her. During that time, she has been completely normal. In fact, it had been enough to make me wonder what had happened to the envelope. Why had she waited until today to try and, in the loosest of terms, stalk me? Miss Ohara falls silent. A little is an understatement. I gaze directly at her and she seems to resign herself a little. She speaks in a small voice. This voice sounds like so different from the voice up until this point. You can kind of tell, like, that's pretty good voice acting. Like, it sounds like her voice is breaking, you know, composure. Like, I feel like I've heard this voice before. This voice actress. I probably have in some other anime, but who knows? Oh, I didn't read the last line. Hold on. It's easy to say it's just a dream, but Miss Ohara looks honestly worried. Is it that much of a problem to have your employer find out that you were thinking of quitting? The world of grown-ups is scary. But then...
やっぱり先生のだったんですか。
違うわ。拾っただけよ。
Miss Ohara uses this opportunity to deny it again. Well, if she's fine with that, then so am I. Nervously, she glances at me. She really does look good in her white uniform. Such unrelated thoughts cross my mind, but even after having thought it over, the only thing I can say remains the same. Same thing I said that day after school. I tell her from the bottom of my heart. I really don't care who the envelope belonged to. I just want her to not worry anymore. She gazes directly at me and I gaze directly back at her. Tonight, the stars are beautiful in the night sky. The sky is filled with stars. Stars from a world far, far away.
Sensei wa kitto watashi no hoshi de.
This is even regardless of the fact that Miss Ohara may quit her job at the academy. Cold night breeze sweeps across and Miss Ohara and I shiver simultaneously. We look at each other and let out a small laugh. The tension ebbs away slightly. Saying this, I attempt to head in the school building first. I walk towards the door. Just then.
Grip!
She clutches my hand from behind. Miss Ohara's hand around mine. I turn around.
Dame.
Miss Ohara has a driven look on her face.
Yappari anshin dekinai.
I'm astounded!
Ima! Kanzen ni rikai shi aita nagare deshita yo! Gomennasai, gomennasai. Demo, watashi...
Miss Ohara's head droops apologetically. Somehow it reminds me of a small child. Well, if I had a dream of being crucified and burned at the stake, I might react similarly. But that being said... All of this is beyond me now. If now were here, she might have been able to come up with a good idea. But she isn't. I consider how she may be worrying about me in our room right now. We remain silent for a while. The sky is filled with stars. Stars from a distant, distant world. A perfect night sky to gaze at with someone you admire. She speaks into the silence. Even in the darkness of the night, I can still see her cheeks flush red. This is my second accentuated of the night. I consider how absurd this is, but she's so serious. It appears this is the only solution she can think of. But come on. She looks downtrodden. I'll tell her a secret. You gotta keep the peace. You gotta tell her a secret. I do have a secret that I can't tell anyone and don't want anyone to find out about, but... Am I really going to tell her? Am I? I like how they make you choose it twice. She's like, come on, player, why are you gonna do this to me? Miss Ohara is looking at me with imploring eyes. Those eyes.
本当の本当の本当に教えちゃう。
It makes you do it three times. It's so funny. I have reached my decision. I know for a fact that if you don't tell her a secret, then it locks her route. I surrender and brace myself for the worst. I'd never thought I would divulge this secret under such beautiful stars, but I return her gaze directly and confidently. Her expression suddenly brightens. There is no laughter in my expression. Miss Ohara swallows and nods with a serious expression on her face. I take a small breath. I tell her. And then? Returning back inside the school building, Miss Ohara and I enter the toilet and emerge right away. She had been able to confirm my secret confessions as the truth, but I'm blushing furiously now. There seems to be a look of admiration on her face. Miss Ohara, your words of encouragement sting. However, enduring the embarrassment and sacrificing my pride as my final trump card seems to have paid off. Miss Ohara appears to have managed to calm down. Yes, I'm glad for that. Sincerely. After all, that was the most important thing, and you know, showing her the fact that I can't grow any pubic hair is by the wayside. I walk next to Miss Ohara in the night air, down to my usual road to and from the academy.
Sensei, この辺で大丈夫です。送ってくれるの。
けど、夜も遅いから。平気です。寮もう近いし。
I stop walking and Miss Ohara stops as well.
あの、ね、おさちさん、
大丈夫です。私、心配いりません。先生こそ気をつけて帰ってください。
そうね。あの、明日からは。
はい、いつも通りで。これまで通りの先生でお願いします。
Miss Ohara smiles bashfully and gives me a small nod.
先生、かわいい。
I can't help myself from thinking this, because I really do adore her. Oh no, I can hardly be my usual self anymore.
でも、いっか。まだ明日じゃないし。
まだ明日じゃないわよね。
My inner voice and Miss Ohara's voice echo each other, leaving me surprised. Then...
Oh! She's kissing my forehead.
Miss Ohara brushes my bangs aside with her fingers, and her lips touch my forehead! Under the starry night sky. For just a moment, the soft sensation. Intimate contact. Miss Ohara quickly separates herself.
それからおやすみの挨拶。
All I can say is, yeah.
おやすみなさい。また明日。
Miss Ohara walks away. There truly is no retreating figure that looks better in the white uniform than her. Hate to see you go, but I love to watch you leave. The words that I had been unable to ask until now fall from my lips absent-mindedly. In response, Miss Ohara suddenly stops. The air around her suddenly begins to sway violently, or at least appears to.
I've been wearing
の実習の時から今までずっと。そんなの嘘よ。
Mizuhara cries out into the darkness. Oops, maybe I shouldn't have told her. My emotions that do not belong to my usual self. Well, it's not tomorrow yet, so I guess I'm safe. Tonight is a beautiful starry night. And I do think there is a very good spot to end the game. We've been going for about 4 hours now, which is a pretty good time. Minus some breaks, maybe 3.5. But I think that's a pretty good amount of time that we've been going. Let's see who we have to raid. There's Donkey. There's Tyler 1. There's Infamous Mountain Dew. There is, we haven't gone to Bakaneko Works in quite a while. So let's go over there to Toby. Playing We Happy Few. They are another VTuber like I am. They are a ghost cat, although it might be a little late for Halloween. But I hope you enjoy the spookiness of Obake Neko Works. Neko Works. I will be back tomorrow afternoon with probably some Mario Kart if my Switch's Wi-Fi works. If not Mario Kart, then something else. And then tomorrow evening, we will continue the story of the Yuri nurses. I'm just trying to go until we get some background noise so we can play ourselves out. Oh, wait. I do have background noise. To celebrate the Atlanta Braves winning the World Series. Thank you, everybody, for joining me. I will be back tomorrow afternoon at about 1 p.m. Central Standard Time with something. Don't know yet. But tomorrow night, 9 p.m. Central Standard Time, I will be back with some more Nurse Love Addiction. And I will catch you cats later.